This is the fifth email I had this year where I am offered the chance to promote hot topics like memes, anime, games, and movie merch. They want me to sell out so they can promote the crap my videos are against. I am not going to be an influencer of cringe anime. Speaking of which, what a crappy episode this was. They wasted the previous season in a war where one-line characters were fighting each other for reasons nobody gave a shit about, and then they end it all with the cast of the previous seasons literally becoming Deus Ex Machina, who jump in the war and stop everything with Hux powers, thus rendering everything the denizens of this world were fighting over completely pointless. Why bother doing anything if gamers with Hux powers can save the day whenever they feel like it? And there are so many stakes in this arc. The tension is really high when nobody can die. The faceless denizens of this world are not real, and the faceless gamers who are real can only lose their avatar. I'm shaking in excitement. You don't even get to see them fighting much because over half the episode is once again people sitting down and talking about boring shit nobody cares about. Because why bother showing it when you can say it and be done with it? It saves you the budget, and the idiots who like video games are going to be jerking off to the terminology. Aggro DPS, macro level up drop rate, this is so deep!
Why are you telling me all this?
It's plot exposition, it has to go somewhere.
And what did you know? That vegetable of a main character is regaining his consciousness when his waifus are entering the game in order to tell him how amazing he is as a vegetable. Who would have thought that out of all the supposed deep themes and complex terminology this series is full of, the answer to how they can make the ridiculously broken main character back to being ridiculously broken and rendering pointless everything that everybody else is doing is to give him his waifus?
What an unbelievable coincidence!
When you know that, there is nothing to care about the fight between the knight and the evil big boss. Yes, he struggled to defeat him and he eventually won. But he achieved nothing in the long run, because the bad guy can return whenever he feels like it without losing a thing. And what is this bullshit about trying to make us believe the villain of the first arc is a good person now, when she had spent the entire first season in being a one-dimensional naked evil slut who planned to consume the souls of countless people for her pleasure? Fuck off, Kawahara, you're pulling the same bullshit as you did with Kayaba, who did terrible things and killed thousands of people for no reason, yet you want us to think he was a hero. Thank goodness you improved your writing and you no longer rely on sexual molestation and one-dimensional evil rapists for making the audience hate your bad guys. That's the shit companies expect me to decry, so they can sell merch through memes. But don't worry, because I will always be refusing.